Aside from obvious issues to do with bundling policy, I just wanted to look at the contribution you made in terms of building up your framework. You know, but of course, like the optical network, you know, terminal installations, and so forth. I'm sure those will go on for some time. But do you foresee a time when this cost will go down? Hence, meaning that you know, what you are charging may also, in future, go down as we develop into a bigger, you know, as we develop the infrastructure. Do you see in the future the prices actually beginning to go up? Forget about what is currently happening with the monetary policy. I don't know whether my question is.
Allow you to increase your cash flows by 250%. Because if it does not, it means we are sinking as a business. And is there a solution to that problem? If you can't make 250% increase in revenue, and that can't come from 150% increase in tariffs, where is it going to come from? Should we put up the red flag and say maybe let's dispose or let's something more logical than to seek a price increase. Perhaps if you can be very blunt and tell going to the situation. I wanted to also ask, you mentioned the fact that you are generating yourselves around $250,000 in Forex revenue. What are the areas where you are generating that revenue? And isn't there a chance to really invest more in those areas so that you can deal with the foreign currency deficit in terms of servicing your external obligations? And we know that at one point, or generally in terms of telecommunications traffic, one of the biggest revenue streams is that of an international gateway. And Tel1 at some point has the monopoly of an international gateway, which you no longer have. Of international traffic, are you handling, or should you be handling, in order to deal with the challenges of the forex requirements that you have spoken about? You also mentioned, Mrs. Mtasa, the fact that all your expenses or your input are in foreign currency except for labor. Should I then understand it to mean you're paying your electricity in US dollars, you're buying your fuel in US dollars, you're paying your rentals in US dollars, your interconnection fees with other operators is being paid in US dollars, or it was just figurative speech? Finally, my question relates to the costs of bringing bandwidth into the country. My understanding is that Tel1 is a shareholder in Wyo, which owns the cable that is bringing the bandwidth here into Zimbabwe. Is there an advantage then in being a shareholder if your obligations in terms of remain as high as they are? I also see from the details you have given us that you have an outstanding obligation of more than $10 million to Wyo, which means these are monies you haven't paid. Isn't your shareholding at risk of being converted to pay off that obligation? And what are the efforts you are taking to make sure that your shareholders? And the reason I bring that up is that perhaps you could, as a background, give a little brief of Tel1 lost its shareholding in Intelsat, which you continue now to pay. And if that won't visit Tel1 with regards to its shareholding in Wyo. I thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Honourable Mandiwanzira. Okay, just the last question.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Okay, my question on the outstanding issues of Tel1. You mentioned that Tel1 requires an urgent foreign currency of $20 million to settle pressing foreign creditors. My question is, what is the interest on the accumulation of that debt, the interest component, on a monthly basis, and are there some legal implications on your non-failure to pay the foreign creditors? Thank you.
Over to you.
Quite an extensive part of our network is copper, and we have actually alarmed, we put up security alarms on the copper. so that there is vandalism and theft during the process, there is an alarm that kicks off and alerts a command center so that our guards and other others are coming out. Another issue is that Tier 1 is collaborating with other players, in particular the TEDC and the security arms of the state in terms of curbing copper theft. Unfortunately, with the issue around copper, the way it poses an opportunity to in terms of forex content, it's actually a daily battle. And what Tier 1 has done as a strategic point is to start replacing certain areas which have got copper network with fiber. In particular, in the industrial areas of Harare, we've actually started that program. Funds permitting, would want to eventually replace almost all the areas that have got copper network with fiber. So that is those are the steps that we are taking. There are campaigns around network vandalism, but it's actually a never-ending battle because we never give up. Quite a stiff penalty of 10 years that is for that instead who's found in the position of stolen property.
But the stiff penalties, I think they are helping you now.
They do assist, but you find that opportunities are many and they keep coming back.
Because I met a lot of your victims when I was at Chukwudi. A lot of people are selling.
That is very unfortunate. It only shows how effective our teams on the ground can be in terms of making the necessary measures to keep. But each time we keep hearing different stories out in the field. On capital costs, when do we expect capital costs to go down? I don't say anytime soon because technology is evolving. However, in terms of deployment of fiber, we are actually behind in terms of deploying the rest of the country with fiber. I'll tell you some of the linkages that we wanted to do. The one that quotes Nyanga, Chipinge, Mtasa into the low field. We wanted to deploy a fiber network on the pylons for the TTDC, as well as the V4's those are fiber routes that we need to deploy in Harare, Nyamapanya. Those are routes that we should deploy the fiber. Those we are lagging behind, and we should actually be able to raise some funding so that we can raise we can deploy. So you give about 2 to 3 years again, we still have some intensive capital work that we need to require as Tier 1. The 250% increase in cash flows coming to only questions, I think it's quite a list of questions, but you attempt to answer all of them. Yes, the 250% increase in cash flows, it's not just the tariff increase that is going to take us up, but at the end of the presentation that I gave, I gave three major issues that are affecting Tier 1. And these were the forex requirements, is then the government and parastatal debtors, and finally the business loans. The issue that will really help us is government paying its bills in time to Tier 1. It is an issue that continuously plays havoc with our cash flows. Right now, the total that we are being owed by government in parastatals is 101 million. Imagine if we got all that land in. That actually is a good RTGS fund from which we can actually fund some of our immediate capex needs. We have an outstanding $5 million project, for example, that is really burning that we need to commission. That can be commissioned. And we can also pay all other obligations in turn. So this again is a continuous call, and this is where your balance vulnerable will come from. We continuously knock on our government, and the fact that we have had a movement of legacy loans, we think that maybe there can be positive movement. but definitely we need this. Right now we have a questionable charge on our P&L for 2018 of 9 million, which is the Zimra penalties and Zimra interest of late payment. If you take off that charge, tell one is in there. So we want this to be addressed, and we and the issue around the cash flow, definitely we really need our views to be changed on time. And the next issue of generating forex, what are the areas? The areas where we are generating forex is where we have interconnection traffic, and we generate forex through that. We also generate forex by carrying IP bandwidth, the traffic across to the other regions. I didn't want to say too much about this deal because we haven't signed, but what is happening is that with the opening of the Byte Bridge link, that bridge to Harare, which then links up Harare to the northern border, we are beginning to see a few opportunities to generate forex because of other players who are seeking IP traffic. Right now, with the WIOC, which Honorable Mandiwanzira was speaking about, we actually are stitching up a $3 million US deal. And once that is signed, it's one area where we are actually going to reduce our indebtedness from 10 to 7 million because of that deal. But this is not the only deal, but I think to a large extent, this to us for this year might be the major deal of the year. But we do have other players who have various other smaller deals who are looking for us transiting. The same way we are being charged by Mozambicans and other South African players, we will also be charged for transiting. We find that a lot of